I welcome you again to the reverse trace design for finite and infinite laminae. It is continuation of the lecture 13. Here I will continue with the reverse trace or the completely reverse trace where the mean is zero, stress amplitude exists, and how do you design for finite life or infinite life of the components. In practice, there are really two types of problems of fatigue design. That is, the component subjected to completely reverse stresses and the component subjected to fluctuating stresses. We have already talked about the fluctuating stresses and the completely reverse stresses. The mean stresses is zero in case of completely reverse cycles, and the stress distribution consists of tensile as well as compressive. That is, for half the cycle it is tensile, for half the cycle it is the compressive, remaining half of the cycle, right? The stress cycle passes through zero, and in case of fluctuating stresses, there are always mean stress, and the stress can be purely tensile or can be purely compressive or can be mixed depending upon the magnitude and the magnitude of the mean stress. Such problems are solved with the help of the modified Godman diagram or the Soderberg diagram or the Gerber's curve that we will be looking in a minute. But design problems of completely reverse stresses are further divided into two groups. See, so the reverse design again further divided into two groups, that is for reverse for infinite life and for reverse completely reverse problem is for infinite life and then for finite life. So if it is for infinite life, then we will be looking for the endurance limit, because the endurance limit is the one where the component will be subjected to at least 10 to the power 6 or 1 million reverse cycle. And in reverse case, the mean stress is zero. The mean stress is zero because it is completely reverse. If this is the stress amplitude, this is the sigma A component, and this is the sigma mean component. And if you see mean component, this is the mean or the average. It is completely half in tensile and half in compressive, and the mean value is zero. And the so if you are looking for infinite problem, so in that case the very easy to design, because you have to choose that the endurance limit is the limit for the failure criterion, and the level of stresses or the stress amplitude should be always less than this magnitude divided by factor of safety. Similarly, if the load is a torsion one and is going to develop the shear stress in the amplitude, and that is fluctuating in nature, that means it is completely reverse in nature, and you are going to design for infinite life, that means life of the component is more than 10 to the power 6 cycles, then you should look for this one, the shear endurance limit also. Like the tensile or compressive endurance limit, you will also have a shear endurance limit. And that divided by the factor of safety should be always will be the limit of the maximum allowable reversed shear stress amplitude that the composite can be subjected. But in the other cases, when we will be dealing with the finite life problem, we have to look for the SN curve. And the SN curve here, we have to draw a SN curve stress in this axis and the number of cycles in this, and both of them has to be in log log scale. This is in log scale, this is also in log scale, and we will be always dealing with the high cycle fatigue. So you will start the x-axis from 3, that means 1000, log 10, log 1000 to the base 10 is equal to 3, and log 10 lakhs or 1 million to the base 10 is 6. So in this case, it is ranging from 3 to 6. But in fact, we have to also put two points. A and B and join a line, and this will be the limit of the SN car. And if the component want to be the load should be within this, that means it starts with this. So this A point, the point A coordinate is 3 comma log 10 90% of the sigma ultimate. So if you know the component is made from some material and we know the ultimate state of the material, then 90% of the that's ultimate strength log value will be the ordinate of the 10 to the power 3 cycles. That is an experimental data, we do it. And then here it will be 10 to the power 6 million cycle, and this limit will be the endurance limit. So SC will be here, this point will be log SC. So the log SC will be the Y coordinate of the point here. This is the 6 comma log 10 SC. So this is the coordinate. This is the coordinate of this. So once we find out, now if you want to find out what will be the maximum level of the a completely reverse cycle of the stress we can give so that the component will be existing 10 to the power 4 cycle. So we mark 4 number here and we draw a point vertical line, and the point when it touches to this one, this will be the limit. That means this value we get, and we take anti-log of that, and that will give you the number, the maximum level of the stress amplitude that the component can be subjected to completely reversed load, and it will exist the 10 to the 4 number of cycles. Similarly, 10 to the 5, any cycles you can find out using this coordinate. So this is about half. So we continue. So we will explain it with the help of some example. So we will draw a triangle, a rectangle triangle, and this point will be the coordinate 3 because it is starting SN curve starting from coordinate 3, and here it is the 6 on the x-axis, so it will be 4, 5, 6 like that, and this point will be corresponding to the value of this will be the log SC. This is log to the base 10 SC, and this will be log 0.9 times of the sigma ut. So now in this triangle, the length of OA, way length will be, the OA length will be equal to log 90% of this. OA will be actually this coordinate minus this one, so that is log 10 of 0.9 sigma ut minus log SC. So that will be way length. Similarly, this will be 6 minus 3, it is 3. So we know this one and this one. Suppose you want to find out what will be the value of the, what will be this, and what will the maximum magnitude of the completely reverse stress amplitude we can apply to the component that will sustain, let's say this. This is 4, this is 5. So what we do, we draw a line. So now we will compare between this triangle and this triangle, or if you want to find out what is the value of this here, so we have to compare between the bigger triangle and the smaller triangle. They are similar triangles. So what we will do, this by this is equal to this by the base, right? Similarly, like for example, in this triangle PXB, in the triangle PXB and OAB, the triangle PXP and OAB, OA by OA, this is OA, OA by PX is equal to OB OA by PX, OA by OB is equal to PX by PB, or OA by PX is equal to OB by PB, that you can do also. So in this, this OA is known, OB is known, what we don't know is PX, and PB is known. So you can find out. So out of this, using the similar triangle frame, if you want to magnitude of the stress, then you can say, if the stress magnitude is known, how many cycles it can withstand, you can also find out if you know this value. So that, this is how you can continue. So we'll do this, we'll explain this with the help of an example. That is for finite problem. This is a problem of infinite life problem. So we'll be considering the infinite life problem. Infinite life problem. That means it will be, it's just 10 to the greater 10 to the number of cycles. So this will exist, this one. So this is about a problem. That is a plate. We don't know the thickness of the place, but the width is known, and there is a hole in the plate, and it is subjected to a pull, which is a completely reverse load. That means it is sometimes pulling and sometimes compressing it, sometimes pulling, compressing, and the nature of the load is it just like this. Just like this. Right? So this is, this is actually 30 kilonewton. This is also, so sigma A is known, and the mean sigma M is equal to 0, sigma A is equal to 30. So it is given. So the plate is made up of steel, and that steel is 20 C8. And when you look at the material, and we see from the table data book, that the ultimate strength of the steel containing 80.8% of the carbon is 440 megapascal. It is 440 megapascal. And this is a hot roll. So this is not manufactured using any other process. It is manufactured using the rolling process. It is manufactured in the, it is a hot rolled plate. So when it is rolled, the surface finish is different. The machining has a different surface finish. The grinding has a different. So it is a hot roll. So the surface finish modification factor is different, we have to consider. And this is subjected to 30 kilonewton reversed axial load. It is not to bending or the torsional load, or it is the rotating bending experiment. It is not like that. It is a axial load. That is, it is pulling along the axis like this. So the notch sensitivity of the material, because it is having some cut, so it is just like a notch, so it is having a notch sensitivity is 0.8, that is Q, and the reliability is expected to, so the designer has expected that it should be working at least 90% reliability, and the size factor is 0.85, because the size is 50, and we know from the table that when the size is more than 50, we have some value. It is between 7.5 to 50, we have some value. It is less than 7.5, we have some value. Because as the size increases, the number of defects in the component will be more. So thereby, the factors or derating factor has to be considered accordingly, according to the different size. So the factor of safety of the component is given to be, the factor of safety of the component is given to be this. So determine the thickness of the plate for infinite life. When it is talking of infinite life, So this is an infinite flow rate. The number of cycles is greater than 10 to the power 6. So what are the data given? Data given is, see, the limit here is to find out the AC value. What is the AC value? If you know the AC value, then everything is done. How do you find out AC? AC is equal to the AC dash into the rating factor like KA, KB, KC, KD, just like that. And how do you find out this one, AC dash? You know AC dash is equal to 0.5% of sigma UT. And this empirical relation we know because we are not testing it, and there is some empirical relation, we will use that. So how do you find out this? Sigma UT is already known. Sigma UT is already known. It is given. If it is not given, we will look from the table. So we will find out AC dash. So AC is equal to this one. We don't know this one. We have to know all these parameters. What is KA? It is the surface finish factor. For cold roll material, the surface finish is different. For machining, it is different. For other purposes, it is different. So for cold roll material, based on the polished surface, it is different. Ground surface, it is different. So this is the graph which is going to show you the how do you decide on the value of K. This side is surface finish. You see, this is machine drawn, this is hot rolled, this is forged component. So we have to find out, and we know the strength is 440. So in this case, you have to go here, and this is a rolled component, so you have to come here. This is almost 0.7 and little less than that. 0.7 for 400, and we have 440, so we have to interpolate, and it is coming out 0.67. So in this case, the KA value is 0.67 that we get from this table. This table will be given in the database, so we will get it from. And 440 is the ultimate strength, and we go and we see this one is this line is the rolled run line, and we reach here, it is 0.7, 0.6, 0.8, between is 0.7, and it will be little more than, and it comes out to be 0.67. Similarly, we have to find out the size factor. The size factor, there is a table. The size factor, you have to find out from this. So this table says, you look at the size factor. The size factor, if the component dimension is less than 0.7, it is 1. That is less, and if it is between this and this, 50, so it is 0.85, and it is more than that, 0.75. Because more the size, more will be number of defects, so the derating factor will be less. So it is, when we found KB value, is this is, and this is 0.85. So 0.85 we have taken. Now out of this we know KB and KA. Then we look for the KC. KC for 90% reliability. Similarly, we have other table that is going to show you what is the value of KC for different reliability. So we find out the value of KC, and we can find out the reliability for 90% reliability. You see, this is the reliability factor table, and that is going to 50% reliability, it is this. 90% reliability is this. 95 is this, and this. So we have 90% reliability, so we have to take this value of KC from this one. So the KC value we have taken to be this one, that is KC is equal to 0.897 KC is taken. Now we have to find out the KD value. KD value is very important, and that depends upon the actual stress concentration factor. KD is actually 1 by KF. This is the actual stress concentration factor, and there is a relation between the actual stress concentration factor and this but theoretical stress concentration factor. And for this notch, having this is having a diameter 10 and this, the entire thing is 50. So 10 by 50 is the dy/w ratio. For dy/w ratio, we have to find out what is the value of this. So we get it from this table. So this is the Peterson curve, and there are for lot of Peterson curves for the this. And from this table, we see the dy value and dy values. And from that we find out, from the table, we find out the value of K theoretical stress concentration, KT. The value of KT we get. The value of KT get from the table is 2.51. But there is a relation between KT and KF. So the KF is found out in this manner. So KT and KF there is a relation, and that we have yesterday discussed. And KT and KF are related by a formula using the notch sensitivity. So the KF is equal to one plus Q into KT minus 1. So the KT is known, this one Q is given in the question is 0.8. So Q is given, this is 0.8. So this is known, this is known, this is known, this is known. So KF is known. So once KF is known, we can find out the KT. So KF in this case is coming out, if you solve it, KF is equal to 1 plus 0.8 into 2.51 minus 1. That is coming out to be 2.208. So KD is 1 by KF is equal to 1 by KF is equal to 1 by 2.208 is equal to, it is 0.452. So now we know this thing. So we know KA, KB, KC, KD and AC dash. So we can find out this one. So the AC dash. So AC is equal to K, KB, KB, KC, KD, K, this load factor and the temperature factor we are not considering here. So AC dash, and this we know it is 90% of the value of 50% of SUT. So this is 0.5 of 440. So this one is the KD value. We obtain 0.4529, and this value we get to KC is the 0.897. This value we get, KB is the side factor, is equal to 0.85. This is 0.67. And what multiply that, we get it is 50.9 Newton per millimeter square or megapascal. But this is for the bending load. This is for, that is, rotating beam experiment. In rotating beam experiment, you see the stresses are like this. That means the stress amplitude is maximum at only 2 points. So maximum at the outer places only, you see. But in axial loading, if you see the axial loading, it is everywhere same, the maximum is same. So there is a defect, so you have to deal. Here it only places the maximum, here at all places the maximum. So you have to reduce the AC by some 70 to 80%. So normally we take 0.8 or 7 AC. This is for axial, that we get, that is equal to 0.8 of 50.9. that is equal to the limit 40.72 is the Newton per millimeter square is the limit. So we have to find out what is the axial load that we should do. So that the limit C axial divided by factor of safety, that is equal to 40.72 divided by factor of safety is 2, that is 20.36. So this is equal to actually PA in this plate having a hole. So this is 50 and this is 40. So width of the plate we don't know, we have to find out the thickness of the plate. So if this is the case, so this is the case and there is load applied. So in this case, the stress is equal to 20.36. That is equal to the load P divided by, load is given, load is 30 into 10 to the power 3 kilonewton. So in Newton I have converted, the width is 50, this is 50 and this is 10, the hole is there. So it is reduced by 10 amount into T. So if you solve it, you get T is equal to some 36.8. For that is equivalent to 37 millimeter. So if you take a plate of this much size, then you can. So in this problem, the main point is to find out AC. So how do you find out AC? AC is found out by, you know, this one. This is, we get from the that is 50.5 of sigma ut. And this we have to calculate the stress concentration factor, and this is, we found out, this is the surface finish factor, this is the size factor, this is the reliability factor. So we have to multiply these factors by looking at the table, and once you find out, this is for the rotating beam experiment, but for axial load you have to still reduce by 80%. And once that is gone, you have to find again the divided by the factor of safety. That should be equal to the load by area. Load by the minimum area. Here the minimum area is this one, 50 minus 10 into T. So that we get, and we get from this. So this is how you should go do for the infinite problem. Because this is the infinite problem, we solve it for the limit is the endurance limit. So this is the case of a completely reverse loading of a component, but here this is not for a infinite level problem. This is that the component will be for some finite level of stresses or finite level of cycles. So whatever will be the case, we will see. So in this problem, a rotating beam made up of 45C8 steel with ultimate tensile of 630 megapascal is subjected to a completely reverse bending stress. So it is a completely reverse bending stress like this. It is completely reverse bending stress, and the corrected endurance limit of the bar AC is given. The AC is given 315 megapascal. Calculate the fatigue strength of the bar for this many cycles, for 90,000 cycle. Now in this case, we know the endurance limit is the one that is going to survive for 10 to the power 6 cycles. So the endurance limit is given. So AC is equal to, it is given, sigma ut is also given. So S sigma ut is given 630 megapascal. AC is also given, that is 315 megapascal, and this corresponds to 10 to the power 6 cycles, and this we know, we have to find out what is the value of the recommended value of the stress, maximum stress we can apply for number of cycle is equal to 90,000 cycles. So what is the value of the recommended value of maximum sigma amplitude, how much we can give so that it can withstand this much number of cycle. Now we have to focus on this cycle, this graph. This is the point A and this is the point B I told you. This point is respect to the coordinate. It is everything in log scale. This is log 10 scale. This is in log 10 scale. Now this point respect to the endurance limit and 10 to the power 6 cycles. So what is the, and this point correspond to the 1000 cycles, that is 10 to the power 3 cycles, and this is 90% of this. So what is the value of 90% of sigma ut? That is 0.9 into sigma ut is 630, that is coming out to 567 newton per millimeter square or megapascal, whatever. Now this corresponds, so the A coordinate is actually 3, log 567, and that is equal to A coordinate is log 567 is coming out to 2.753, so it will be 3, 2.7536. So what is the coordinate of B? The B coordinate is the x coordinate is 6, because log 10 to the power 10 to the power 6 is equal to log 10 to the 6, this is the 6. So log 10 to the power 6 is equal to 6 into log 10, so this is 1, so 6 into 1 is equal to 6. So this coordinate is 6 comma log 315, and that we get is equal to b is equal to 6 comma 350 is 2.4983. So this is, so while these 2 points are known, now we want to find out this location. So this location is actually log 10 90,000. So we get log 10 90,000 is equal to 4.9542. So log, this is 4.92. So this is known. So this is, this point is 4.9542. Now what is the value of this? We can find out by this, from this two triangle. So what is the value of, if you compare these two triangle, this triangle and this triangle. So let's say this. So comparing between this and this, we can find out the value of this one. So how do you find this much divided by this much is equal to this much divided by whole. So what is the value of OB? OB is equal to 3. What is the value of this one? OA. OA is, this is equal to 6 minus 3. OA is equal to actually 2.7536 minus 2.4983. So we find OA is this much. This is, you see, so OA is this y coordinate of this minus, so OA is 2. This minus this one, that we are getting. So once we know this, so what is the value of this? This we don't know. So this we have to know. So from this similar triangle, this and this, OA, let's say this is the x coordinate, let's say P, from the triangle PXB, from the triangle PXB triangle and triangle OAB, we can find out AO by PX or PX by AO is equal to PB by OB. So OB is known. So PB magnitude is PB. What is the value of PB? PB is actually this minus this. PB is actually 6 minus 4.9542. So on solving, we can find out this PX is equal to PB by OB into AO. So this is known, this is known, this is known. So what is the value of PX? So So once we px is known, so we can find out now the value of, so the px is equal to px is equal to pb divided by ob into a. Pb is this one, ob is given, and ao is given, so we find out that, and the total ordinate will be this value plus the value of px. So this is going to give you the, if you take antilog of that, you will get this value. So this will be the limit of the maximum stress amplitude we can give for the this coordinate. I will be referring to this coordinate, will be referring to the level of stress, which is equal to 386.63. So if you are applying this much of amount of stress, that is going to survive for 90,000 cycles. So in this case, we will be talking about the cumulative damage in fatigue, cumulative damage in fatigue. With the help of this example, cumulative damage in fatigue, or we say it is Miner's equation, and this is given by the Miner. This is happening in certain applications. The mechanical component is subjected to different types of stress levels for different parts of different cycles. The life of such components is determined by the Miner's equation. Suppose a component is subjected completely reverse stress by magnitude of alpha 1. By magnitudes, let's say sigma 1 for n1 cycles, and it is also subjected to another level of stresses sigma 2 for n2 number of cycles, and third it is subjected to another cycle by other number of cycles. So the component is subjected to different kinds of levels of stresses, which is completely reversal in nature. Suppose for sigma 1 amount, it is subjected to n1 number of cycles. For sigma 2, these are all completely reverse cycles, reverse load. So we are sigma 2 for n2 and sigma 3 magnitude. Sigma 3 magnitude for n3 number of cycles. These are cycles. So the component, sometimes it is subjected to sigma 1 for n1 cycles, and it is subjected to sigma 2 magnitude of reverse stresses for n2 cycles, and so on. And let n1, capital N1, be the number of stress cycles before the fatigue failure. If I say n1 is the number of cycles for fatigue failure, if you subject sigma 1, only sigma 1, so obviously this is less than this, and if sigma 2 is only applied, it will withstand only n2 number of cycles, and if sigma 3 is applied, it will only, this is applied, only this one is applied, only this one is applied, so maximum it is subjected, it can be subjected to n3 cycle. So if you subject, suppose sigma 1 is applied, it will sustain, only sigma 1 is applied, it will sustain n1 number of cycles, n1 cycle. Suppose you apply one cycle, so what will be the life? It will be consuming the life by one cycle of sigma 1 applied, so it will be consuming this. If n one number of cycles is applied, for sigma 1 magnitude, then the life of the component will be n1 by capital N1, right? It will be capital. Similarly, if you consider part by part, if you consider the part by part, then the if sigma 1 is applied for n1 cycles, the life consumed will be n1 by capital N1, where n1 is the number of actual cycle applied, and this will be the maximum cycle it can withstand if sigma 1 only is applied to the component. If you are only applying this much, then it is going to withstand. Similarly, if you are going to apply sigma 2 for n2 number of cycles, sigma 2 for small n2 number of cycles, the life of the component will be n2. So, how many number of different types of loads you are going to apply, and it will consume the total life. So, total life is 100%. So, n1 by n1 plus n2 by n2 plus n3 by n capital N3 plus dot dot will be equal to 100%. Right? Similarly, this will be the proportionate damage by sigma 1. Proportionate damage caused by sigma 1, and proportionate damage caused by sigma 2 is this one. Proportionate damage caused by out of the total life. So the above equation, this is known as the Miner's equation, right? Sometimes number of cycles n1, small n2 and smaller stress level, these are unknown. Sometimes these are unknowns. So what you do, we know, suppose that alpha 1 and alpha 2, alpha 3 dot dot are the proportion of the total life that the component will consume by stress level sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3, etc. And if n is the total life of the component, then so n1 will be equal to alpha 1 into n, n2 will be alpha 2 into capital N, like that, where alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 are proportions of the total life, are the proportions of the total life that will be consumed, by sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 respectively. So this will be, if you replace this one here, so the Miner's equation, so alpha 1 into n by n1 plus alpha 2 into n by n2 plus alpha 3 into n by n3 plus dot dot will be equal to 1. So in this case, if you take n common and divide, so alpha 1 by n1 plus alpha 2 by n2 plus alpha 3 by n3 plus is equal to 1 by n. So you can find out this. So, and where alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 3 plus dot is equal to 1. This is known with the help of these equations, the life of the component subjected to different stress levels can be determined. And we will be explaining this, the Minor's equation for finding out the cumulative damage in the fatigue with the help of an example. So this problem is a problem that with the help of this we can understand the cumulative damage in the fatigue, and this is known using the Minor's equation. And the work cycle of the mechanical component is subjected to completely reverse bending stress consisting of the following three elements. That means how 80% of the lifetime it is subjected to a stress level of 300 megapascal completely reversed, and 400 megapascal 12% of the time it is subjected to, and 3% of the time it is subjected to the 500 megapascal. So the sigma 1 is equal to, in this case, is 350 megapascal, and the alpha 1 in this case is 0.85, because 85%. Sigma 2 is equal to 400 megapascal, and alpha 2 is equal to 0.12. Sigma 3 in this case is equal to 500 megapascal, and the alpha 3 in this case is equal to 0.03. The material is made up of this, and the ultimate strength sigma ut is equal to this. This is given. So new, before going to the advance, this is given, and this is a completely reverse loading. We can find out what is the value of this 90% of sigma ut, because you have to draw a SN curve like this, where this side is the number of cycle, this side is in stress level, but those are in log scale. So this point will correspond to 3, 0 log 10 90% of the sigma ut. So 90% of sigma ut is equal to 594, and when you take log of that, we get, so this coordinate is 3, 2.7738. This coordinate is known. Now the endurance limit we can find out. The endurance limit is given in this case. The corrected endurance limit is equal to 280 megapascal. So it is given. We will find out the AC is given. We don't have to find out. So it is given, and we take log of it, and we get the point coordinate. The 6 is the endurance limit, because it will sustain 10^6 cycles. So that's why the coordinate will be 6.24472. So once we know, we can find out this, the complete triangle ABD is known, because you know this point, you know this point. So this is known, that is 6 minus 3 is 3, and this is also known. So this entire thing is known. Now, if you are applying the stress magnitude of 350 megapascal, what will be the cycle it will withstand? Let's say this 350 megapascal will correspond to a point, this one. So what will be the corresponding level of the cycles it can withstand if only 350 megapascal is applied, 350 megapascal reverse cycle is applied to this. So the fatigue life of this will be found out by using the comparing the triangle, this triangle and this triangle. So in this triangle, this is known, this point is known, this point is known, this point. But in this triangle, we don't know what is the value of this. Only we know this one. Because once you take log of this value, 350, we get this point. So once you find out this point, the F point, we can find out the value of FC using this FC is equal to the log of log 10 of 350 minus log 10 of 280. So you will find out this one. So this we don't know, but this one is not. So we can use the similar triangle. So EF, or you can compare this triangle or this triangle. Once you find EF by AE is equal to DB by AD. So this is DB by AD. So this is the triangle we are comparing. these two triangle compare, you can get it the value by comparing this triangle and this triangle. Now we are comparing this triangle AEF and ADB. So this by this is equal to this by this much. So this point AE point we will find out by this. So the corresponding the value of F can be find out from this solving this equation. One similarly we have to find out the corresponding value of N. This N, the number of cycle that the component will be subject can withstand if subjected to a magnitude of 400 megapascal only. Similarly, the point corresponding to this point in x axis, we have to find out corresponding this one. Once you find out this one, so you use this minus equation. N1 is this is 0.85, this is 0.12, this is 0.3. And this we have already found out, this we have already found out, and this. So the value of N1, N2, and everything is known. And using this, we can find out the total life of the component. That is equal to 1 by N. So the N is can be found out using this one. Let us solve that. So this will be. So the calculation of N1, N2, N3. Calculation of capital N1, N2, N3. N1 is corresponds to N1 is number of cycle the component will sustain if sigma 1 is only applied. So how do you find out? So you have to find out by comparing the two triangle. That triangle is explained in this way. So triangle this and triangle this. So AE by AD is equal to EF by DC. So from that we can find out. So that is equal to EF.